Welcome to a video on horizontal and vertical tangent lines to polar curves. In the last video, we discussed how to find dy dx when the equation is in polar form using this formula here. So to determine where a tangent line is horizontal or vertical, we just need to draw some conclusions about this formula. What I mean by that is dy d theta measures the change in y with respect to theta. So if the change in y with respect to theta was 0, we would have a horizontal tangent line. So if a tangent line is horizontal, then dy d theta is equal to 0. And dx d theta measures the change in x with respect to theta. And if the change of x with respect to theta is equal to 0, we would have a vertical tangent line. So if the tangent line is vertical, then dx d theta is equal to 0. Let's go ahead and see how we're going to apply this. We want to determine where the tangent line would be horizontal and vertical to r equals 1 minus sine theta. Let's start by finding where we have horizontal tangent lines. And this will occur where dy d theta is equal to 0. So we're going to determine f prime of theta sine theta plus f of theta cosine theta, set it equal to 0, and solve for theta. So dy d theta will equal f prime of theta times sine theta. F prime of theta will be the derivative of 1 minus sine theta, so that'll be negative cosine theta times sine theta plus f of theta, 1 minus sine theta, times cosine theta. Now remember, to find horizontal tangent lines, we're only concerned about dy d theta, or the numerator of dy dx. Let's go ahead and distribute here. Set this equal to 0 and see if we can solve this equation. So we'll have plus cosine theta minus cosine theta sine theta equals 0. We have two like terms, so we're going to have cosine theta minus 2 cosine theta sine theta. And now we can factor out the common factor of cosine theta. We'll be left with 1 minus 2 sine theta. So this is equal to 0 when cosine theta is equal to 0, and when 1 minus 2 sine theta is equal to 0. If we solve this equation here for sine theta, we would subtract 1 and then divide by negative 2. We want to know when sine theta is equal to positive 1/2. And before we do this, we should recognize that we're going to trace out this entire plane curve on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. If we take a look at the graph of cosine theta, we look something like this. We know the period is 2 pi, so cosine theta is going to equal 0 at pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. And to determine where sine theta is equal to 1/2, we first need to recognize that sine is going to be positive in quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. And if we draw a 30 degree reference angle in both quadrants, these two angles would have a sine ratio of 1/2. So this would be 30 degrees, or pi over 6. And this would be 150 degrees, or 5 pi over 6. So what we'll do now is take these four angles, sub them back into our original equation to determine what the radius would be. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. So when theta is pi over 6, we'll have r equals 1 minus sine pi over 6. Well, sine pi over 6 is equal to 1/2, so r is equal to 1/2. So we have the point 1/2 comma pi over 6. When theta is equal to 5 pi over 6, so we have r equals 1 minus sine 5 pi over 6. This is also equal to 1/2, so we have 1 minus 1/2, which is 1/2. So we have the point 1/2, 5 pi over 6. When theta equals pi over 2, we have r equals 1 minus sine pi over 2. Sine pi over 2 is equal to 1, so this would be 0. So we have the point 0 pi over 2. That's going to be at the pole. And then lastly, we have 1 minus sine 3 pi over 2. Well, the sine of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1, so we have 1 minus negative 1. That'll give us 2. So we have the point 2, 3 pi over 2. So from our work, we can expect horizontal tangent lines at these four points. But let's go check. Notice upon closer inspection, there's only 3 points that actually have horizontal tangent lines. We have one at 1 half pi over 6, 1 half 5 pi over 6, and another horizontal tangent line at 2, 3 pi over 2. Notice at the point 0 pi over 2, or at the pole, we do not have a horizontal tangent line. So it is important that we check the points on our graph. It is true that if dy d theta and dx d theta equals 0, no conclusion can be made about having a vertical or horizontal tangent line. And we'll see that next when we go to find the vertical tangent lines. Let's go ahead and do that now. So now we'll do the second half of this problem where we want to find where we have vertical tangent lines. And we have vertical tangent lines when dx d theta is equal to 0. So we're going to find f prime of theta cosine theta minus f of theta sine theta, set it equal to 0, and solve for theta. Let's go ahead and try it. So we'll have f prime of theta times cosine theta. F prime of theta is going to be negative cosine theta times cosine theta minus f of theta, which is 1 minus sine theta, times sine theta. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We're going to have negative cosine squared theta. Distributing here, we'll have sine theta, but it's going to be minus sine theta. And then we'll have a negative sine squared theta here, but we're going to subtract that, so it's plus sine squared theta. We want to know when this is equal to 0. Now notice in its current form, we're not going to be able to solve this equation, but we can get this all in terms of sines if we replace cosine squared with 1 minus sine squared using the identity sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. So this will be negative 1 minus sine squared theta minus sine theta plus sine squared theta. Now when we simplify this, notice we're going to have a positive sine squared theta, and there's another one here, so we'll have 2 sine squared theta, and then we'll have minus sine theta, and then we'll also have a minus 1. Now this equation does factor. We're going to have 2 sine theta in this position, and sine theta in this position. We want the inner and outer sum to be negative sine theta. So if we put a negative 1 here and a positive 1 here, we'll have negative 2 sine theta plus 1 sine theta does give us negative sine theta. So now we want to set these factors equal to 0 and determine what theta would be. So here we'll have sine theta equals negative 1 half, and here we'll have sine theta equals positive 1. So from this equation, we know that theta would have to be pi over 2. And then to determine where sine theta is equal to negative 1 half, well, we just determined when sine theta was positive 1 half, that was in the first and second quadrant. So now we'll have 30 degree reference angles in the third and fourth quadrant. So we'll have 210 degrees, which is 7 pi over 6. And then we'll also have 330 degrees, which is 11 pi over 6 radians. Now let's go ahead and determine what r would be using the equation r equals 1 minus sine theta. And let's do that on the next screen. So when theta is pi over 2, we'll have r equals 1 minus, well, sine pi over 2 is equal to 1, so r is 0. So we have the point 0 pi over 2. Remember, we found the same point when we were looking for horizontal tangent lines. For 7 pi over 6, we'll have 1 minus sine 7 pi over 6, which is negative 1 half. So r will be equal to 3 halves. So we'll have 3 halves, 7 pi over 6. And then lastly, we have r equals 1 minus sine 11 pi over 6, which again is negative 1 half. So we have 3 halves again. So these are the points where we expect to see vertical tangent lines. Let's go ahead and check that. So here we have the point 3 halves, 7 pi over 6, where we would have a vertical tangent line. And here's 3 halves, 11 pi over 6, where we also have a vertical tangent line. But notice at 0 pi over 2, or at the pole, we do not have a vertical or horizontal tangent line because we have a sharp point right there. So once again, it is important that we do verify our points by looking at it graphically as well as using our calculus techniques. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.